In August this year, Chinese tech giant Baidu announced that it secured permits to commercialize the operation of its Apollo robotaxis in the city of Wuhan in Chongqing. Baidu's move to offer a driverless experience in China adds it to a list of companies that include Zoox, General Motors Cruise, and Alphabet's Waymo, which have also introduced similar offerings. It's an impressive forward step for sure, but it begs the question, are these robotaxis what people had in mind when talking about self-driving vehicles? Not quite. For starters, consumers still can't buy one for themselves. The vehicles that currently operate as robotaxis aren't purchasable. They also only operate under specific conditions, within a confined area, like a city, or within an industrial zone. Their shortcomings have also made the headlines more frequently than we'd like to see. So what do all these represent for the state of self-driving vehicles? The fact that they're now operational does suggest that autonomous vehicles could be becoming viable. And perhaps, just perhaps, we're close to a point of breakthrough, where we'll soon be ready to hand over driving duties to software. But are we, really? For us to know where the world stands in its development of self-driving vehicles, it's important to first determine what an autonomous vehicle is and what it isn't. Definitions vary, but there's a growing consensus among experts that they can be categorized across 6 levels, from 0 to 5. Traditional vehicles fall under the level 0 category. They are manually controlled, and humans perform all essential driving tasks, such as steering, acceleration, and braking. They may be fitted with assistive systems such as emergency braking, but since they don't maneuver the vehicle, they don't qualify as automations. Level 1 vehicles are those that can automate a single driving task, but only under certain conditions. Vehicles with cruise control is an example, since they can control their own speed automatically while on highways. Level 2 vehicles are capable of automating more than one driving task. Automations remain conditional. They will only function properly in certain scenarios, such as within a geographical boundary. They also need to be supervised by a human who's alert to the surroundings, allowing them to intervene if required. Tesla vehicles that are fitted with the company's autopilot system are examples of Level 2 vehicles. Level 3 vehicles are a significant step up. They can automate all essential driving tasks, and they are equipped with fallback systems that activate in the event an unforeseen scenario is encountered or when the intervention of a human is needed. Automations of Level 3 vehicles are also conditional. Level 4 vehicles are nearly identical to Level 3, with the exception that humans should not be needed to intervene in any way while they are operating. Vehicles equipped with the Waymo driver system, as well as Baidu's Apollo robotaxis, are examples of Level 4 vehicles. And finally, Level 5 vehicles are the holy grail of self-driving developments. Their automations can be executed unconditionally, and when they encounter unforeseen scenarios, their systems are ready to react appropriately and autonomously without human intervention. At this point in time, we don't know any company that's capable of or close to producing Level 5 vehicles. It's 2022 now. Perhaps companies have kind of underestimated how complicated it is to build a vehicle that can drive itself. For example, most self-driving vehicles in development right now are designed to utilize a mix of LiDAR, cameras, and sensors. They provide data that can be analyzed using software to let the vehicles know how to navigate their environment. To be clear, plenty of progress has been made in these areas, and there are systems that have now become reliable enough to operate as long as their environment stays somewhat predictable. But self-driving vehicles need to account for many variables while they're on the road, such as other vehicles, signages, people, animals, random structures, and more. And they have to do so quickly. The instruments that serve as their eyes and ears can also be affected by inclement weather conditions like rain or snow. And let's just say we figured all of them out. The world, as we know it, might not be ready. Road infrastructure in many parts of the world are laden with issues, ranging from potholes to poor lane markings, connectivity issues, and more. Diving straight in without addressing these issues would expose people to too much risk. When we do overcome the technical challenges, ethical dilemmas will take over. Self-driving vehicles have been touted to improve road safety by removing human error from the equation, but accidents will remain inevitable, the vehicle shouldn't be expected to stop every possible accident from occurring. The issue is, when an accident involves a self-driving vehicle, who's responsible? You can't technically punish the vehicle. So should it be the passenger, the developer, or even the other party who takes the blame? These are difficult questions to answer, but it's important that they are adequately addressed before self-driving vehicles take to the road en masse, since the answers we arrive at will have major implications on legal regulations, insurance, and more. Now, don't get us wrong. Despite the problems at hand, self-driving vehicles have immense potential to change our world for the better. Roads can be safer, travel times can be shorter, and self-driving vehicles could even be utilized in ways that traditional cars can't. Here's what Elon Musk had to say.
So there will be a shared autonomy fleet where you buy your car and you can choose to use that car exclusively. You could choose to have it be used only by friends and family, only by other drivers who are rated 5-star. You can choose to share it sometimes, but not other times. That's 100% what will occur. It's just a question of when.
If you're one to trust Elon Musk's words, he claims that the development of Level 5 vehicles are closer to completion than we think. And this year, 2022, might just be the year that it happens. Whether it's going to happen for real this time, well, only time will tell. That's it from us for now. If you'd like to watch more of our content, you know, subscribe and shit.